Hi everyone, welcome to a new Begijnhoeven special. My name is Rob and today we're going to have a look at my two-year-old at the stables of Gwen Vogely. She's training them and we're going to explain what we do with them and how we build them up towards the stallion selection. And we also answered lots of questions from Instagram stories. We got lots of cool questions, so thanks for all the questions. So yeah, I hope you like this video. Enjoy! So this is Gwen.
Hi.
Gwen is taking care of the young stallions and the young mares for a few years now, I think. Last 3 years?
Third year.
When they come out of the field, she's doing the first part and she's making them ready to go to the stallion selection or the mare selections. So this one is a two-year-old Toto Junior out of Fabiola, my Fabiola. I think it's a very interesting stallion. And yeah, we're going to have a look at him now.
I think he's been here now for 8 weeks.
8 weeks already?
Yeah,
okay.
I think something like that.
Yeah, and he was a little bit wild, no?
Just a little bit, just a tiny little bit. yeah, he didn't know a head call or anything. So, and he was, as you can see now, he's still very awake.
That's good. In the future, it's good.
Yeah. In the beginning, it was a little bit difficult, a bit spooky with getting the head collar on, and he was too scared to walk with me through the stable and go outside. So, but Frans helped me a lot, the stable owner. So thank God now he's much better. He's getting there. Now he has a trust in me, and now, yeah.
We always forget it takes lots of time because, of course, the horses don't know much. They only know the field and they're in the herd. So they need to know what a halter is and that they walk on the rope and that kind of stuff. And it's really basic stuff, but it takes a lot of time and patience to do that. And many people forget it. This first step is really important for the future as well.
So we just saw the Toto Junior walking loose, and it was, I think, really good. Very nice movement, very much suppleness in his gaits, and it's still lots of power. So I like that combination. Sometimes we miss that in the Dutch one boots, I think. And you see in this horse, it's a little combination of Dutch and German. And yeah, I really like this horse. What I especially like is the withers. It's very long. It stretches only until here, so it's a very long withers. So it means he has a great overtrack in his front legs, especially. So yeah, you can see it in his movement. So yeah, I think it's a very good horse, and he's really pretty as well. So that's also not too bad. Stallion. He is the half brother of Le Premier, so he's also out of Feti. He was the best foal of his year back then. Everybody was like, whoa, he has so extremely good gaits. And now it's still a very good mover. We had some doubts in the way he was built in his back, because he was growing like this. So he had a little bit a strange back. But he's growing now in the right way, and he's getting nicer and nicer. And it's always a little bit complicated with two-year-olds, because they're like teenagers. They look a bit weird sometimes, and you have to have patience and try to see how they were as a foal. And many times they will be the same in their building when they're three-year-old. But when they're two, they're a little bit, yeah, out of proportion. So it's kind of hard to look at it the right way, but when we see him now, I think it will be fine in a few months. That he, yeah, I think it will be very pretty horse, and I think a very good horse as well.
This one was a little bit different than the Toto when he came in. He was very curious, and he always came to you as soon as you opened the stable. The only problem that I had with him was as soon as he came outside, he was like, oh, okay, it's more fun there back in the field, so bye-bye now. So that was a bit difficult in the beginning, but we fixed that as well now. And yeah, this is a horse that he's always keen to work and yeah, always happy. And
he looks happy.
Yeah.
That's good.
He's always happy and always fun, so yeah. Yeah.
Kleiner dan fokken. Nee.
So we have our cup of coffee again. Gwen, how long do you do this, or how did you came to this job?
About 20 years ago, I started as a groom for KB van der Heijden. And I did that for 10 years, and then I went to another place to be a groom, and then I ended up at Joop van Uithart, a big stallion station in Holland. And there I started to get all the stallions and the mares ready for the mare and stallion grading. So I did that for 5 years, and after that I thought, maybe I'll do this for my own.
On my own.
I have 11 stables and a wash place, and I'm waiting for the new building to come for an indoor arena for the lunging.
Cool.
And an indoor walker, so I'll be very happy when that is finished.
Luxurious stuff.
Yes.
Okay. We just saw the two stallions, and I saw them a few weeks ago. And it's amazing how they change in a few weeks. And I think now the second one was maybe even better than the first one for me. Yeah. But I like them both, so they can stay. maybe we can explain them what the plans are for the next few months with these horses, because I want to take them to the BWP for the stallion selection. And the first thing is that they have to be vetted. And you have to go there to Ghent, to the university clinic. How do you call it?
University clinic.
But I always do the vetting in January, February already, where the young stock is. And so I already know they're healthy on the x-rays. And because you want to invest in horses that you know they are healthy. But I think the first step is we have to go to Ghent.
Yes.
And what's now your plan with training? Because the second round is the BWP selection in January, so we still have
a few months.
A few months. I was trying to count, but okay, a few. But how do you build up to January?
For now, I think it's very important to get a little bit more condition, because then they move a lot, but we do a lot of this, what we showed you just a minute ago, in the indoor, so they can know that they have to trot inside and they can't only spin around and go really fast. We also start up lunging a little bit, but yeah, they're still young, so we built that up very slowly. At the moment, they only know the bridle and a little bit the lunging, and then we start up with a girth and draw rein, so they go really light in draw reins, because we also have to do that on the BWP stallion grading in January. Mm-hmm. So we have to teach them that, but I think at the moment the most important thing is to let them grow, feed them a lot and let them grow and get condition, and
Well, you're doing it really well, because they change a lot in a good way, so that's
thank
good.
Thank you.
If it was not in a good way, then something's wrong. Yeah. Yeah, it's really important with the young horses that you do it only step by step, and because they're really young and the muscles are not there yet, so you can't force things too much, because then you get injuries and that kind of stuff, and we don't want that, because this is just the first step for their career. I mean, the most important step is when they're 8, 9, 10 years old, so they have to make it until that age, of course. If you do now too much, things will go wrong, I think.
Yeah, I think so too.
Yeah. What do you think of these two? I didn't ask yet.
Well, I'm very happy with these two, because I think they're both very talented horses. Both have their different pluses and minuses,
yes.
But that's with every horse. But I do like the movement of both of them, and
they're very different,
and also the character is very different, but I love both characters, because one is a little bit cheeky and the other one is like, oh, I have to trust you, and I love both of that, and I'm really pleased with these two horses.
And you did Le Premier, the Millennium Stallion, 2 years ago. It was a very good stallion, and Quinton you did as well.
Yes.
That was a good year. Do you think these two are better? And Fredot is the half-brother of Le Premier, so do they see comparisons? Or?
I do see comparisons, but they are different.
Yeah.
Because Le Premier was also a little bit shy in the beginning, but he It's difficult to explain, but he was different. But yeah. I do see
similarities
in the building as well.
Yeah.
So yeah.
But this one has more electricity,
yeah,
I think,
exactly,
yeah? more
exactly
activity.
Yeah.
And Le Premier has more swing.
Yeah.
But I also see similarities.
Yeah.
It's strange.
I think when we're further on in the training, when they have a little bit more training on the lunge line, then it's easier for me to see what's the same.
Yeah. Well, I think now the if you see how talented they are in their basic gaits, I maybe think these are better than those two, but of course you see them now in sports and they do really well and they developed really well. So of course we don't know still. So
yeah.
it's
still very early in the process.
Coffee thick looking. So we asked you guys on Instagram stories if you guys have questions for Gwen, what we do with two-year-olds when we train them up. We got quite some questions, so we're gonna have a look. Someone being called Just Moments by me, not a real name, I think. what's their week schedule?
That depends on the horse.
Yes,
because every horse has a different schedule. So but it has the going free in the big arena, a little bit of lunging. A little bit walking in hand, because of course very important for the stallion grading.
Yes.
But that really depends on the horse.
Yeah, what they need.
What they
right?
need
yeah.
and what they can handle
yeah.
and their age, because some of them are a little bit older. But,
yeah. But you have to give them rest as well, of
yes,
course.
Yes, very
so
important.
How many days rest they have to get at least?
At least 2-3 days,
yeah.
at least.
Okay. Okay, next question. What do they need to know for the stallion selection?
For the BWP, they need to do the free in the arena, and they need to go in hand. They go on the hard surface for the first day, so you have to trot and walk in hand, and then they go on the soft surface as well. Then you have a triangle where you have to trot in. That's also in hand, so of course they need to know that's really good. And on the last day, you need to go on the lunge line.
Yeah.
With draw rein, so they have to know the lunging with the girth and the draw reins, and yeah.
Yeah, so a lot.
Yes.
Yeah. This is an interesting question, also quite kind of hard. Karin Weber, on which age you see the qualities of a young horse the best? Maybe we can both answer
yeah,
that.
Yeah, I think that's also
difficult.
A good question for you, because
yeah.
that's very difficult.
Yeah. We always see them as a foal, of course, but many times they change. But the really special ones, many times, are also special as a foal. There are some exceptions that the foals are normal and that they turn out to be very special three-year-olds. But till now, when they're really special as a foal and they're still healthy and they're big enough and the character is good and they're correct in the way they're built, many times they're also good as a two-year-old. But when Gwen is trying to train them, I mean, you see them develop really good.
Yeah.
So you also see a big difference when you started them and then 6 months later, right?
Yes, of course, yeah, definitely. I don't see them a lot as a foal, because
they
are two-year-olds when they come to me. But I often had started a young stallion at a two-year-old, and I thought, it's okay, it's nice, but yeah. That's it.
Yeah.
And then after 2 months, I'm like, ooh,
like, woohoo,
missed
yeah.
that one.
That's
really,
that's
really good.
What age do they start with the training? And what work do you start with?
The stallions start at 2. Mares
yeah.
start at 3.
But when, what's, yeah, in summertime, it depends a little bit.
Depends.
So it's like July, something like that.
Yeah, August.
Really quiet.
July,
yeah.
we only learn to handle
yeah.
them, but then August. A
catch
bit
them
work.
On the halter and that kind of stuff. It's also important. And what work do you start with? Yeah, that's the basic stuff.
The
right?
basic stuff, really
yeah.
basic. Walking in hand, brushing, washing.
Oh, this is a good question. How do you make them that they focus on you and not on the mares? Yes, how do you do that?
Yes, that's a very good question. Well, in the really beginning, I make sure there are no mares. because if they don't know anything, they will not focus on me, and I can do whatever I want, but that's
not
going to
happen. Keep them separate.
Yes. But you will see after a while, when you've been training them for a little bit, then they know what's expected from them, and the focus stays with you. And of course, you have stallions that never stop noticing the mess.
You have bastards between them, yes.
But when your basic is fine, then they focus with you.
Yeah. Okay, last one. Where do you mount them for the first time? In the stable or in the aisle? It's something else, actually, because Gwen is not breaking them.
No.
And I think it's important that Gwen is doing the first job, because they need to be strong enough that you can sit on them. If the back is not developed, then it's not really smart that you sit on the horse, because you have a weight, of course, as a rider. That's not for Gwen.
Yeah, and of course they're very young when they're here, so we don't sit on
two
horses.
No, we have to wait when they're three. Yeah, that's better. Okay, that were the most of the questions. So this was an interesting morning again. So thanks, Gwen, for showing the stallions. It's really interesting, I think, to see the development. If you like this video, leave a thumbs up or a comment, and don't forget to subscribe.